Welcome everybody, I'm Dr. Shweta Sharma, working in the Department of Applied Science and Humanities, Faculty of Engineering and Technology. In this video, I will be discussing about the aspects that are associated with the pollution. So if we talk about the pollution and define pollution, then pollution can be defined as any undesirable change in the physical, chemical and biological properties of air, water or soil that is injurious to the health of plants, animals or human beings, and it also deteriorates the quality of our natural resources. And if we define the pollution in terms of the sphere which is being contaminated, then the pollution can be defined in three broad categories. It can be air pollution if the atmosphere is being contaminated or polluted, and it can be classified as water pollution or defined as water pollution if the sphere related with hydrosphere is contaminated, or it can be defined or classified as soil or land pollution if the land is being polluted. The pollution can also be classified into two categories. It can be non-biodegradable pollution and it can be biodegradable pollution. If we talk about non-biodegradable pollution, then the non-biodegradable pollution or the pollutants are those substances that cannot be easily degraded, or it takes a very large amount of time to degrade these substances. The example of non-biodegradable pollutants are metal, especially the heavy metals like lead, mercury, cadmium, arsenic, nickel. These heavy metals are very toxic to the human beings. In addition to the metals, plastics, polythene bags, long chain phenolic compounds, these are also the examples of non-biodegradable pollutants. The peculiar property which is associated with the non-biodegradable pollution is that they show the property of bioaccumulation and biomagnification. So bioaccumulation means if these pollutants are present in any source and any organism is consuming or ingesting these non-biodegradable pollutants, then it is going to be accumulated in the body of that particular organism, and it is being accumulated in the fatty tissues or in whatever organ it is being going to. The another property is biomagnification. In the process of biomagnification, the quantity or the concentration of these particular non-biodegradable pollutants is magnified as it passes through the subsequent trophic levels and it moves in the food chain. The next pollution or the pollutant is biodegradable pollutants. The biodegradable pollutants are those substances or those pollutants which can be degraded very easily by the natural agencies, and the examples of biodegradable pollutants are domestic waste, kitchen waste, municipal waste, etc. These can be degraded very easily in a matter of few days. So we in the next section we will talk about the different pollutants. So the first section is the air pollution. And if we define air pollution, then the air pollution can be defined as the presence of foreign substances like gases or particulate matter in such concentration, in the concentration above threshold level, which is injurious to the health of the plants, animals and human beings, and it also interferes with the full use and enjoyment of the property or the wealth which is created by the man. So the common air pollutants are gases like carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, oxides of nitrogen, oxides of sulfur, ozone, yeah, particulate matter, etc. We can also classify or we can also divide the air pollutants into two basic categories. The first is the primary air pollutants. The primary air pollutants are emitted directly from the source and remain there in the form in which they were emitted. The examples of the primary pollutants are carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, oxides of sulfur, oxides of nitrogen, many pollen grains which are liberated or detached from the trees, bacteria, viruses which are suspended in the environment. They remain there in the form in which they were emitted, and their form is not changed during the course of the time. The next pollutant is the secondary pollutants. The secondary air pollutants are those pollutants which are formed as a result of the interaction between or the chemical reaction between two primary pollutants, or it can also be formed as a result of chemical reaction between primary pollutant and the constituents of the air. The example of the secondary air pollutants can be the oxides of nitrogen and sulfur. When they react with water, they form acid droplets. The acid droplet is an example of secondary air pollutants. Similarly, aldehyde, ozone and PAN. These three are formed as a result of interaction of nitrogen dioxide with the sunlight and the hydrocarbons. The oxides of nitrogen and hydrocarbons are emitted from the automobile exhaust during the transportation process, and in case of intense summers and traffic jam, these are emitted in huge amount and they can react with the sunlight and form ozone, aldehyde and peroxyacyl nitrate, which is also called as PAN. And these are very toxic air pollutants and they are also secondary pollutants. So this is the classification of the air pollutants. In the next video, I will be discussing about various air pollutants, what are their sources and what effect they cause on the plants, animals and human beings. This is all for this video. Thank you.